Jaya Radha
Madhava
Punya Vihari.
So we are reading the shloka from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 8th chapter, 12th verse. Shri Garga Uvacha Ayam Hirohini Putro Ramayan Suhrdo Gune Akshayashati Rama Iti Baladhikyad Balam Vidhu Yadunam Apratak Bhavat Shankarshanam Ushanti Api. So, time is a little short. So, we'll just begin with the translation and the purport. Translation, Garg Muni said, this child, the son of Rohini, will give all happiness to his relatives and friends by his transcendental qualities. Therefore, he will be known as Rama. And because he will manifest extraordinary bodily strength, he will also be known as Bala. Moreover, because he unites two families, Vasudev's family and the family of Nanda Maharaj, he will be known as Shankarshana. Purport by His Divine Grace is Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Baldev was actually the son of Devaki, but he was transferred from Devaki's womb to that of Rohini. This fact was not disclosed. According to a statement in the Hari Vamsha, Pratyuvach Tato Ramah Sarvamstan Abhitahastina Sithan Yadayevesh Api Sarveshu Bhavanti Mama Vallabha. Garg Muni did disclose to Nanda Maharaj that Balram would be known as Shankarshan because of uniting two families, the Yadu Vamsha and the Vamsha of Nanda Maharaj, one of which was known as Kshatriya and the other as Vaishya. Both families had the same original forefather, the only difference being that Nanda Maharaj was born of a Vaishya wife, whereas Vasudev was born of a Kshatriya wife. Later, Nanda Maharaj married a Vaishya wife and Vasudev married a Kshatriya wife. So although the families of Nanda Maharaj and Vasudev both came from the same father, they were divided as Kshatriya and Vaishya. Now, Baldev united them and therefore he was known as Shankarshana. Om Agyanti Mirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurum Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Utash Patakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishnavastam Cha He Savdetam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Namaum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Bracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Translation, Garg Muni said, this child, the son of Rohini, will give all happiness to his relatives and friends by his transcendental qualities. Therefore, he will be known as Rama, and because he will manifest extraordinary bodily strength, he will also be known as Bala. Moreover, because he unites two families, Vasudeva's family and the family of Nanda Maharaj, he will be known as Shankarshana. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to serve all the devotees here. And I would like to beg forgiveness if I'm speaking beyond my realization or if I'm committing mistakes in my class. Because I'm just speaking here, sitting here for my own purification and on the order of devotees and Guru Parampara. So please tolerate me. So today is the most auspicious day of Balaram Jayanti. Shri Balaram Ji Ki! So I know that everyone is on fasting and everyone is tired since morning program and Abhishek, Kirtan, all these things are going on and little tiring faces I can see. But you know, Balaram is Shakti, power. You know, so you have to say loudly, Balaram Ji Ki! That's how it is. Great. So, today the very auspicious day of Lord Balaram's appearance day as well as today is Purnima. These two tithis are coming together. So, in the material world, Purnima is considered like the materialistic people, they are become so devotional for Purnima. You know, today Purnima is there. I'll do this, I'll do that. We'll follow certain vows, this vow, that vow. And today is also Raksha Bandhan. So Raksha Bandhan is also a very important festival in India. Yeah? And everyone is so happy. The sister is thinking, you know, I'll get a lot of gifts today from my brother. And the brother is thinking, oh, I believe in debt now today, you know. I have to give everything to my sister. So everyone is in a festival mood today. And actually, we think that, okay, you know, for us devotees in ISKCON, Prabhupada has created this festival to be a big festival of Balaram Jayanti. But in the outside world, it's Raksha Bandhan more, Purnima more. So the outside world, people are celebrating Krishna Janmashtami more than Balaram Jayanti. In fact, Balaram Jayanti, other than Vaishnavas, people doesn't... We just went to, yesterday, to one of the temple in the Thondanur place, you know, this place is nearby. The King Battiswami. So there the Pujari, we told him, oh, Balaram Jayanti, Balaram, tomorrow is a festival. No, we make Krishna Janmashtami, Krishna Janmashtami. So Krishna Janmashtami is the festival which is famous all over the world. But Balaram Jayanti is not that famous. So today, we have got an opportunity to actually understand that what is this Balaram Jayanti and what understandings we can get, what learnings we can get from today's day. So I've just acronymed the word Balaram because I was thinking how to present. And whenever we try to give a class, we try to think what is the audience all about, you know, what kind of audience will be? Young, old, Matajis, Prabhujis. So here is a mixed crowd. So just to take you through a proper sequence of certain lessons, we'll be acronyming the session completely in the word as Balarama. So the very first word B stands for binding force. Now, here in the purport, Prabhupada is speaking about two families. Talking about Nanda Maharaj's family and Vasudev's family. So Nanda Maharaj is a Vaishya. And Vasudev is a Kshatriya. So for a Kshatriya, to get bond with a Vaishya is only money, which can bond, you know. Because Vaishya has money, Kshatriya has to work hard. So in the Varnashram system, getting into two caste relationships is very not from the heart, aisa. Okay, superficial. Some business, that's all. But over here, we see that Vasudev and Nanda Maharaj, they are best of the friends. And they are coming both from the same father. And Baldevji is actually uniting them. It's a bonding, basically. So today, in this material world, when we talk about bonding, as Raksha Bandhan is there, so there is a bonding between sister and brother. But have you heard any festival made or any kind of vows been taken between a brother and brother for bonding? There's a bonding between guru-disciple, husband-wife, brother and sister. But any brother-brother bonding vows or some kind of a festival made? No. So it is Balramji actually, who is actually setting the trend. He's giving this kind of a festival where actually, you know, there should be a bonding between brother and brother, between two families. Today, as the world is running towards Western culture, people are not staying together, they are in nuclear family. And so many partitions are happening. So joint families are rare to see. Maybe because of job, because of this, that. We as a family, my family, my brother-in-law is Braj Kishore Prabhu. So I came here for a get-together, a family get-together. My brother, my both the sisters, and we just came together. So the concept of bonding is basically been lost slowly between families, between different age groups, because of, you know, the son says to the father, you know, there's a generation gap. You can't understand me, you know, I'm like this. And you never understand because it's a generation gap. So a lot of difficulties are coming because there's no binding force. The binding force is Balaram. That's why he is also known as Shankarshan. He's binding. What he's doing is binding the devotee to Krishna. He's taking a devotee towards Krishna. That is the binding force. And Gauranga said in one of the classes, which I heard long back, but this statement stuck to my mind, or maybe you can say to the heart, not mind. He says that Balramji, what is his weapon? Hala. So Balramji's weapon is hala. So why? What is the use of the hala? It's plowing, right? It's created traction. So Gauranga Prabhu said that Balramji uses his plow and he let the plow go through the field of bhakti in the heart of the devotee. Every devotee's heart is a field of bhakti. You know, there is watering done, so many things are done. So the plowing is done by Balramji. So Balramji creates a traction in the heart of the devotees. So that what happens? So that it creates attractions toward Krishna. That is the work of Balramji. Isn't it? So this is the binding force. Now, B is for binding force, B-A. Correct me if my spelling is wrong. Many people speak Balarama. So I have taken B-A-L-A-R-M. So A is appearance. So let us discuss a little bit about the appearance of Lord Balaram. So who is Balaram? Balaram, Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Right? And Baldev is also Supreme Personality of Godhead. So what is the difference? Baldev is called as the brother of Krishna. They are both same, but the only difference is the color. Krishna is, what is the color of Krishna? Krishna is dark bluish, monsoon cloud color. Whenever we see rains, it's very rare to see in Bangalore, but the clouds are seen a lot. So don't worry, if you don't get the rains, you get to see Krishna's color. Right? And then Balaram, Balaram's color is white, white clouds. Somebody said that, no, it is said in one of the places, I heard from one Prabhuji, that the color of Balaram is like the color of the white whirl inside the white lotus. So this is the color of Balaramji. So this is the only difference between both of them. Otherwise, everything is same. Now, what has happened? How did Balaram appeared? So it is said in Bhagavad Gita, Janma karma chame divyam evam yeti totaptata evam veti totatvataha tvaktva deham punarjanma eti maam eti so Arjuna. Krishna is saying to Arjuna that Arjuna, my appearance, your appearance, people appearing in this world is like, you know, it's just coming out of a womb. But appearance of mine is divine. It's not a regular appearance. So to understand this is not our capability. But we can always hear the pastime, we can always narrate the pastime and get purified. We may not understand it clearly that, okay, you know, aisa aisa hua tha, achha, what happened at that exact time? I want to see, I want to know how it happened, kaise, you know, how the womb was transferred to Rohini's womb. We can discuss it, but we may not go so much technical into it that, you know, okay, you know, I have to just know it. It is not possible for us to understand the activities of Krishna and Balaram. We can just hear the pastimes. So what has happened is Devaki and Vasudev, they are in the jail. And here, Kamsa has already, you know, told Devaki that I will kill your 8 sons. I will spare your other sons. And Narad Muni, he comes up. Radhikaramana, Radhikaramana, you know, he's chanting. And what he does, he keeps chanting and he goes and he tried to, he's like a catalyst. He tried to expedite the process because he is more eager to have darshan of Lord Balaram and Krishna. So he's catalyst, he says to Kamsa, that Kamsa, are you sure that the 8th son is going to kill you? And then he gives the example of the rose flower or a lotus flower where the petals, which one is going to come first, clockwise, anti-clockwise. And then Kamsa get confused. We also get confused in our life, but not by Narad Muni, but by the people, those who are the pseudo Narad Muni. They are thinking that, okay, you know, we'll make fool of people. We'll have this mutt starting and then we'll tell people, if you do this, you'll get this. And then we get fooled. Oh, astrologer has said like this. And this is connecting to my desire. So now I should do this. I've been into more youth preaching in Mumbai in ISKCON Youth Services. So one of the boys said, and I told him, come on, start working. And earn some good money. And try to serve devotees, serve your parents. And he says, oh, my astrologer has told me that I am good as a teacher. And I also like it. So I'll become a teacher. I said, come on, this is what you're actually fooling yourself. You want to do something and you're taking help of the astrologer so that he says the same thing. What about the willpower? What about the mission? Service to Srila Prabhupada's mission, where you actually have to contribute in a way. So nowadays, it has become a fashion, you know, oh, teaching is a noble profession, why to get in to all those things, and we'll teach, and we'll live a simple life. That's great. But if your qualities or nature is not to be a teacher, then you won't do good in that. You won't excel into it. So the very important thing is to know one's own nature. What is one nature is. Coming back to the point where actually I was trying to say that this pseudo Narad Munis are actually so much that they are actually trying to fool us. And when we get fooled, and after getting again and again fooled, if we have come once to the shelter of Krishna, Krishna will again pull us. So who is doing that pulling work? That is Balaram, Guru. Guru does that. Balaramji pulls you back. Huh? Isn't it? There's a famous story Gauranga Guru always quotes in his classes about a Prabhupada disciple who said, Prabhupada, I am enough with bhakti, I want to go back. I want to enjoy material life. And he goes to Hawaii. And he is doing sea skating, surfing, suffering. So he's doing surfing in the ocean, and while he's doing surfing, there is a shark which is coming around him. And she's going around him, is in the center. And he realizes that what Prabhupada told him. And he understands, and all of a sudden he prays to Prabhupada, he prays to Krishna that please, you know, save me this time. I will never leave Krishna, your lotus feet, I will never leave. And the shark goes, she does a parikrama and goes away. So that's where actually Guru, who is the Adi Guru, is Balaram, is going to pull us back. Huh? So that is how we have to be always under the shelter of Guru and devotees. Now another thing is Balaramji is also very beautiful, isn't it? So his beauty is also one thing which is actually standing differently from Krishna. When Balaramji was born, the astrologers, they said that he will kill many demons, and his, along with his younger brother Krishna. They didn't name the name of Krishna at the time, but you know, at the birth time, they predict something. So there was a prediction, just like Prabhupada at the birth time, he was predicted that he will create 108 temples all over the world. And at the age of 70, he will do that. And it happened. So the Kannada translation is going on, so I'll go a little slow, I'm a little fast. So coming back to the story of birth of Balaramji, so Yashoda Devaki, she was, her six sons were killed, and the seventh son, the news spread that it's a miscarriage. But actually what happened? It was, the womb was transformed to the yoga maya potency in the womb of Rohini, and Balaramji appeared in Gokul, Vrindavan. And when he was a child, Yashoda Mai sometimes used to pick him up and put him in her lap, and all of a sudden Balaramji used to become happy, and as soon as he was kept down, he used to cry. So this activity of Balaramji or Krishna or the personality of Godhead may appear to be normal. We may think, oh, my child is Krishna Balaram. This is a very common thinking, you know, people carry when they don't have a philosophical background. They think, you know, my child is so quiet, you know, and they start getting attached to the bodily affections of the child. And they are not able to give the actual understanding to the child. How to actually give that knowledge of Krishna consciousness and their real education to the child. But they just get fascinated with the child's activities and they just make the child happy, 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 happy. But then one day they realize that actually they could not do anything for the child's spiritual upliftment. The third word, the first word was B, the second word was A. B was standing for binding force, A for appearance. The third word is light, L. L stands for light. Balaram is Guru. Om Agyanti Mirandasya Gyananjana Shlakaya. So he's actually, he's like a torchlight. He's putting the torchlight. And when torchlight is put to our activities, everything is exposed. So Baldev Balaram, he is our Guru. So we have to understand that what is Guru Tattva. We may not really understand it because, you know, it's very deep subject matter. But some light we all try to throw on real position of Balaram. So Chaitanya Charitamrit, in the Adi Leela, in the fifth chapter, the fourth verse, I'll read the verse. Sarva avatari Krishna Swayam Bhagavan Tanara Dvitiya Deha Shri Balaram. Translation goes like this. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is the fountainhead of all incarnations. Lord Balaram is his second body. In the purport, Prabhupada is saying, Lord Shri Krishna, the absolute personality of Godhead, is the primeval Lord, the original form of Godhead, and his first expansion is Shri Balaram. The personality of Godhead can expand himself in innumerable forms. The forms that have unlimited potency are called Swamsha, and forms that have limited potencies, the living entities, are called Vibhinna Amsha. Little technical, but it's very important because I believe many of you have been coming. Maybe this is the second Balaram Jayanti. And third, then for me practically I came to temple when I was a school boy and I attended many Balaram Jayantis, and after many attending I could not understand actually what is the understanding of Swamsha, Amsha. And when I started reading Bhagavatam and actually then, you know, started hearing classes sincerely, then I understood, okay, little bit. So, you know, this is something which we need to understand at the very spur of the moment. You know, when you are there for 1 second Balaram Jayanti, aapko samajh jana chahiye. So, don't take much time. So, we'll try to just touch this technical area. So, in this shloka, there are certain things which are mentioned like Swamsha, Vibhinamsha. So, position of Balaram. What is Balaram? He's a Amsha, Vibhinamsha. We'll try to understand. First of all, we will understand that what Mayavadis are having a misconception about Lord Balaram. Mayavadis, they think, in the Vedanta Sutra, it is mentioned that, you know, Balaram is not Vishnu Tattva. They say like that. But he is an ordinary Jiva. So why to celebrate his appearance day? Why to worship him? But there are many flaws in that. And what are the flaws? The explanation is given by Shripad Ramanujacharya. Now Shripad Ramanujacharya himself is Shankarshan, Anantashesh. So he's explaining clearly in the Pancharatra that Vasudev, the expansion of Krishna are quadruple. Vasudev, Shankarshan, Pradyumna, Aniruddha. Now Vasudev is original, Vasudev himself. And Jiva, Shankarshan is considered by Mayavadis as Jiva. And Pradyumna appears from Shankarshan. And they say that Shankarshan, it's understanding that the Pradyumna who appears from Shankarshan is the predominating deity of mind. And Aniruddha who is appearing from Pradyumna is the predominant deity of ego. So the problem lies that they say that Shankarshan is Jiva, is the predominating deity of Jiva, the living entities. But actually, we see that in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 7th chapter, the 4th verse, it's saying, Bhumir aponalo vayu kham mano buddhi revacha ahankarityam me bhinna prakriti astada. It is said that earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence and false ego, all together, these 8 constitute my separated material energies. Okay, so you understand, mind is also a separated, ego is also a separated material energy. But over here, what we are saying, Vasudev se kon aata hai? Shankarshan. Shankarshan se kon aata hai? Pradyumna. And Pradyumna se? Anirudh. It's coming, right? So how it's possible from a jiva, a living entity, that Pradyumna and Shankarshan, Anirudh can come? Because they are the predominant entity of mind and ego. And here Krishna is saying mind and ego is a separated energy of mind. Living entity is a separated energy, jiva is a separated energy. So what does that mean? That means that Balaram or Shankarshan is the predominating deity for the living entity for Ashray, Guru. That is the actual meaning and which the Mayavadis could not understand that. Okay, so this is a very small point. Now we want to also put some light on the planetary expansions and expansions. Huh? So there is a shloka, in Chitta Chitamrit, saying, Amshe Ramsha Yai Kalataranam Govindera Pratimurti Shri Balaram. What it's saying, that Amsha is the first expansion of Krishna. And Kala, that is expansion of Amsha. But he's saying, Amshe Ramsha Yai Kalataranam. Huh? What it's saying, that Balaramji, what is your name? You are not Amsha, you are not Kala, you are Govindera Pratimurti. Pratimurti, you are the same as Govinda. Huh? And who is that? Sri Balaram. So this is what actually is the understanding, the position of Balaramji. Huh? That he is non-different than Krishna. Now, first one was B, binding force. Second one was A, appearance. Third is L, light. And the fourth word is A. A stands for attitude. The attitude to serve. So now we understood the position of Balaramji. Now let's go little ahead and understand what Balaramji thinks of himself. You may be, we all may be thinking about Balaramji same to be as Krishna, but now we try to understand from Balaramji's point of view. So he's saying, he considers himself as servant of Krishna. Huh? Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Apanaika Bhrityakari Krishna. Direct, I'm Krishna himself. No, he's not saying like that. So that is the attitude what Balaramji is carrying. And in further section, we'll also understand how we can apply this in our life. Again in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it's mentioned, 5th chapter, 5th shloka. Ekai swarupe done bhinna matra kaye adya kaye vyuha Krishna lila rasahai. These two are one and the same identity. They differ only in form. Lord Balaram is the first bodily expansion of Krishna and he assists in Lord Krishna's transcendental pastime. Very clearly made by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. So the purport is saying, Balaram is a Swamsha expansion of the Lord, again confirmation. And therefore, there is no difference in potency between Krishna and Balaram. The only difference is in their bodily structure. Okay? As the first expansion of Godhead, Balaram is the chief deity among the first quadruple forms and is the foremost assistant of Sri Krishna in his transcendental activities. Again, the attitude is to be assistant but in the foremost position. Pehle, any service given has been rendered first by Balaramji. Many a times in our life, we think there is a service announced. This year, the Janmashtami service has come up. So dear devotees, we have to go out and ask for donation. And there are many other services. We have shoe stall seva, we have this seva, we have that seva. So please give your names accordingly. And when we are not inspired in bhakti, what we think? So many devotees are there, they will do seva. I will just chant. And I will hear Bhagavatam, Katha. And when I will hear, I will get the desire to serve. So it's very easy, you know. And it's already fasting day, you know, the whole day I have to fast. So if I'm going to fast so much, how can I do seva? Already I have hyperacidity, this, that, all those issues. And now Ayurveda has come, so my pitta is high, cough is low, this dosha is there. So much knowledge is floating in the air. So catching that knowledge and trending it to my way, what we are actually trying to, it happens with me also. Actually, it's my story I'm telling you. So, but the, over here, Balaramji is teaching us that he's the foremost of the servant. Any service you get, he will do it. So his primary duty is to aid Krishna in his pastimes. Seitananta Shesha Bhakta Avatar Ishwarera Seva Bhinna Nahi Janayar. So what is happening in the shloka? It says Ananta Shesha. So Anant is unlimited. Anant means unlimited. So he does service. Whatever service he does unlimited. I'll tell you my personal experience. Once I went for this 2005 May, the first time the Panchatattva were installed was in 2005, isn't it? And 2006 was the second year, again they did the Abhishek. So I didn't got a chance to go in 2005, so I went in 2006. And over there, I was trying to get some seva, you know. Some seva, kuch service mil jayega, something or the other. And somebody told me, go to this Prabhu. I forgot his name. And like he was a Russian devotee. So I went to 10 devotees and all the 10 said, go to that Prabhu. He will create some seva for you. I was shocked. You know how seva is created? Seva has to be already defined, right? If we are in corporates or if we are in a proper convent school or management B schools, everything disciplined and planned and everything is there. So we think that, you know, life has to be defined. The day has to be defined. But here, this person, this devotee, is getting a position or getting a tag that he creates seva. That's what Balaramji does. So this devotee, what he did? He said to me that you stay with me and you will get seva. So I just, okay Prabhuji, I'll stay with you. And then he was doing seva throughout the day. Next day was Abhishek and I was trying to be with him. I could not cope up with him. And in the night time he got fever. And it was already 1 o'clock and we were in the backup room of Panchatattva. And I told one of the other Prabhuji that, you know, Prabhuji, now it's 1 o'clock and next day we have to be up for the festival, you know. And we want to do more seva, but let's have some rest. And here this, I told this Prabhuji, we are going. Go, no problem. So he's detached, you know. And I said, Prabhuji, but everything is clean. The backup room is clean, everything is set. Tomorrow morning we will come and we'll do more things. No, Prabhuji, actually, you know, there is some seva. So what he did? The Kalash Patra, the silver Kalash Patra, which is used to bathe the lordship, they fill it from the tank. They used to be the lordship. That Kalash Patra had the corners have come out. And he started thinking, if the pujari or the sannyasis who are going to bathe Panchatattva, if their finger gets cut with that, you know, the sharp edge being coming out. So he started hammering or doing and trying to make it straight. I was like, full dandavats to this Prabhu. You know, that where this seva has appeared from. So Balaramji is actually, he's a person who does all the services. So there are few things which Balaramji does. He becomes a chhatra. Chhatra is umbrella. He becomes the paduka, footwear. He becomes a shayya, the bed. Upadhana, that is pillow. Vasana, that is vastra, that is clothes. Then Arama, that is couch, to rest for Krishna. And Avasa, that is home. And Yajna Sutra, he even becomes a sacred thread for Krishna. And Simhasana, the asana, the Simhasana where Krishna sits. So he does all this and unlimited services to Krishna. It is said that all the paraphernalia used for Krishna service is Balaram. It is said Mridanga is Balaram, Gartal is Balaram, all Kirtan instruments are Balaram. Everything engaged in the service of Krishna is Balaram, the mic is Balaram. Even this laptop has become Balaram because it's glorifying Krishna's qualities, Balaramji's qualities. Srila Prabhupada said that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and Balaramji is the servitor God. He teaches us how to do serving, service. So there is a small pastime in Chaitanya Leela where Advaita Acharya is trying to glorify Lord Chaitanya Nityananda. So Advaita Acharya is saying, Chaitanya Radas Muni, Chaitanya Radas, Chaitanya Radas Muni, Taradase Radas. He's saying that I am servant of yours, Chaitanya. I am servant of Lord Chaitanya. And I am not only the servant, I am the servant of the servant. And then he says, Premadhana Bina Vyagraha, Dasa Kori Vetana, Mora Deho Premadhana. He's saying that without being a servant of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityanand Prabhu and the devotees, how can I achieve the love of God? So this is the words of Advaita Acharya. So here we understood the importance of seva. Now the next word is R. The word R is respect. Now every one of us want respect in life, isn't it? You know, there is a seminar, Celebrating Others' Success, very famous in ISKCON. Have you attended? There should be one here if it's not happened here. This seminar teaches you that how important it is to celebrate others' success. If you are successful, then I should be happy. Isn't it? Because there is a need that we should be glorified. Hare Prabhu, what a service you have done. If you have done so much service and no one comes and the sacrifice is not observed, then you feel so sad, you know, your enthusiasm goes down. But as soon as someone comes, so I'll just share one personal realization in my life that I've always been identified with my brother and family in my spiritual life, material life. So when I came to temple, I was known as my brother's brother because I was young. And later on, you know, I was continued to be known like that. Then I got initiated. Then I started doing some seva here and there. Then I become a monk. So still, you know, I was introduced to senior devotees like, you know, he's his brother, you know. I used to think, yaar, this is what, you know, am I not done anything? That I've been always called as my brother's brother. What is my identification? So this was not a very boiling desire in my heart, but it was lying somewhere in the corner of my heart, you know. And Guru knows that. So Radhanath Swami, you know, once he came to Govardhan Eco Village. So I had fortunately got some seva over there under Gauranga Prabhu. So Maharaj came and near his cottage, Gauranga Prabhu introduced me. You know, Maharaj, his brother's brother. And I was thinking, you know, still I am my brother's brother. And Maharaj, Jai, Radha Krishna Bhagwan, what did he say? Jagannath Baldev, Subhadra Diti Ki Jai. So I was thinking, you know, this there. But Maharaj, all of a sudden, he said to Gauranga Prabhu, his brother is his brother. He said the other way, and I was like smiling like anything. This is the day, you know, I never forget. Why? Because there's a need of recognition. There's a need of respect. There's a need of appreciation. Everyone was looking at that. Huh? But Balaramji's case is not like that. He's devoid of respect. There are four sampradayas. Huh? Lakshmi sampraday, Brahma sampraday, Rudra sampraday. Huh? And the fourth one is Kumar sampraday. Is there any Balaram sampraday? Come on, he is the Adi Guru. But there is no sampraday on his name. Nothing is left for him. Huh? So Balaramji doesn't want anything. What he wants is just service to Krishna. So Balaramji came as Lakshman. And as Lakshman, when he came, he was serving Ram without any desires. When Ram was given banishment to the jungles, Lakshmanji never thought that what will happen to my wife, what will happen to my family life, and all those things. He just got ready with a bow and arrow and said, I'm coming. So Lakshmanji never thought of that. Then, in another case where actually the most toughest part of his life was, you know, Lakshmanji was asked by Ramji to banish Sita, Mother Sita. So in our life also, we have so many situations where we like something but we don't get to do it because our service is something else. Isn't it? Right? So when we are involved in seva, we need to understand that what is the priority, what is the seva is more important service. We have to keep our likes and dislikes aside, you know. Like Gauranga Prabhu, he was sharing that, you know, when he joined the ashram, all of a sudden, you know, the shlokas started appearing to him from the Bhagavatam. As if he has been, you know, reading it from years and years and like previous life. It was like so simple for him. And then, you know, he started giving discourses and then he became a kathakar. And now, what is the next stage? You know, I want to go more deep into Jiva Goswami commentary and you know, all those things. And all of a sudden, you know, Maharaj comes. Gauranga, what are you doing? Maharaj, I'm thinking to go for VIHE, MIHE for the studies. Maharaj said, you know, we are making new stones here, you know. We are putting the Jaipur stones in our temple. So I think you should get involved in the construction. Gauranga said, but Maharaj, I want to study. Maharaj said, this taking care of the temple and the deities is what your studies is. You will get more realizations by doing that seva. And it was a big sacrifice. Many times we think that our services are not to be known by anyone. You know, what am I doing? 12 saal ho gaya, 10 saal ho gaya, mandir aate aate. You know, what I've been doing? Bas wohi charnamrit every day. So we want to have recognition. But when we give up our desires and we sacrifice, like Lord Balaram, Lakshman, then we are identified in the eyes of Guru and Krishna. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says that don't try to see Krishna, try to serve Krishna. So that Krishna wants to see you. And there are unlimited stories on that. Going ahead, even Nityanand Prabhu was not spared. Isn't it? Nityanand Prabhu was also asked to do a seva, which was so difficult for him, to go away from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself was from, the hometown was Navdeep, Bengal. But he could not, after taking sannyas, he could not do much of the preaching in Bengal. Why? Because people were thinking, you know, differently about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because already he was known as a scholar, as Nimai Pandit. So certain impressions were been carried and people were talking differently for him. So Mahaprabhu went to Jagannath Puri. He went to South India, but Sankirtan movement in Navdeep was spread by Sri Chaitanya Nityanand Prabhu. Nityanand Prabhu was ordered that go in Navdeep and spread the holy name of the Lord. And that was so difficult for Lord Nityananda to be separated from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that's what is absorption. The next A is absorption. We understood about tattva, we understood about service, we understood about difficulties in seva. This all will be understood when we are absorbed in our services. What is absorption? Absorption is something where actually you don't get bothered with the other things. Recently, we had a Prerna festival in which the topic was Overcoming Distraction by Gauranga Prabhu. And Gauranga Prabhu was mentioning that what are the modern distractions? Now the distractions are not earlier. My mother always says to me, you know, that when your brother was young and when there was a marriage celebration going from the roadside, he used to never go out and see what's happening. He used to be in his books. But you are always out only, not studying. You're getting distracted. So this kind of distractions were there in our young age. But today, the distractions are not those. They've changed. They are iPhones, smartphones, WhatsApp, Twitter, Facebook. These are the distractions. There's a joke in Hindi. You know, a devotee friend told to another devotee friend, Hindi mein hai, "Are itna anguta mat ghuma. Agar itna anguta tu mala karte vakt ghumata, to golok poch jata." Because the anguta is the thumb and you start scrolling from your left hand, WhatsApp. What's happening? Like this. But yahan ka anguta ruk jata hai. The anguta here stops. It doesn't go like this. You know, it doesn't move. The beats don't go down. So this kind of distractions are prominent today. And to overcome these distractions, we have to be determined in our absorptions. So there is a small pastime of Rath Yatra. So in the pastime of Rath Yatra, what happens is Lord Balaram is basically absorbed, totally absorbed. He doesn't know what's happening outside, whether people are waiting for him to come on the Rath. He's totally absorbed, he's totally unmad in the love of Krishna. He's not bothered of anything, and the Daityapatis are trying hard, you know, chal baliya. And the Balaram is not moving, you know, it's so heavy. It's very heavy. Have you tried any time, you know, touching Balaram? Very heavy. So that's where Balaramji shows the example that absorption we should have if somebody is trying to pull us away from Krishna. Chal, aaj movie ke liye jaate hain. Let's go for a movie. Or if a devotee is there, Prabhu, chalo, let's have some fun. Let's go and play cricket. Chalta hai. Everyone plays cricket. Body thoda fit hona chahiye. Some kind of distractions, any type of distractions which come on the path of devotional service, we should remember Balaramji. So that is how it is. Lord Balaram is the another character of Lord Balaram. There is when Balaramji is moving, you know. So the rhythm of the chariot which is created, it's very beautiful, very soft. And the four horses that pull Balaram's chariots are Tivra strength. First one is Tivra. The four horses which are pulling Balaramji's rath, cart. The first one's name is Tivra. That means strength. Second one is Ghora. That is consistency. Ghora means consistent. And Dirgha. Dirgha is timeless, unlimited. And the fourth one is Shrama, work. Hard work. Work, Shrama. Action, seva. So even the four horses of Balaramji's are named with the qualities of Balaramji. So this we can understand from the Rath Yatra pastimes. I just took two points. Next we go ahead with this, the another A, anarthas. So over here, we are having different anardhas in our heart. Lord Shivaji Maharaj, when he went to Tukaram Maharaj in Maharashtra, and some other, he identified that Tukaram Maharaj is the real saint. And he told his Senapati Moropant that, you know, Moropant, you go home and tell my mother, I'm not coming home, I'm busy. So Moropant said, but what about the fort? What about the kingdom? Who will protect it? So Shivaji Maharaj said a beautiful statement. He said that I am now busy in conquering the enemies, conquering the forts within my heart of anarthas, lust, anger, greed, pride, envy. So this is what actually our real job is. We may be software engineer, businessmen, doctors, students, housewives, teachers. But when it comes to our own personal sadhana, our main point is to overcome these anarthas. And there is a small story. One pastime we'd like to discuss. We have time, Prabhuji? One small pastime we'll discuss. This pastime, is of a demon in Krishna Leela. And it shows that how we should actually overcome this anartha in our life. Balaramji is trying to tell us through this pastime. Set up the scene, it's Vrindavan. And Krishna and Balaram with friends, Gopa friends are going out with the calves and they're playing and the calves are grazing. The trees are beautiful, water is flowing. Bangalore is a very good city here, the climate is good. We went yesterday to Melukote. We heard that in Melukote, Krishna came. And it is named as one of the Vrindavans, you know, where actually Krishna came. There is Rampriya deities. And Krishna, the deities were worshipped in Dwarika. And when Balaramji came here, Balaramji himself came here. He came here in Melukote and he saw the deity of, the main deity of Tiru Chalvanarayan, Tirunarayan Swami. So that deity, when he saw that, hey, this deity looks similar to the deity which we are worshipping in Dwarka, Ramapriya. So Balaramji went back, told it to Krishna that, Krishna, this is how it is. Then Krishna and Balaram, they both came with the whole family. The whole Yadu dynasty came with the family and they brought the Rampriya deities and kept here in Melukote. So that's where actually Krishna and Balaram also visited Karnataka. So we were going around and we are seeing cows everywhere on the roads. You know, and we were experiencing that, you know, how Vrindavan is manifested here. And that's how, in this pastime also, the very pleasant atmosphere where actually everything what the gopas wanted, Krishna was providing. So few gopas actually got some fragrance. No, actually few gopas, they wanted to play games. So when we try to play games, we try to think that who has played this game before. Just like cricket. As soon as you say cricket, whose name you remember? At our age, we remember Tendulkar. Now maybe Dhoni, somebody else. So all the games are originated from Krishna only and Balaram. So there is this game of tug of war, and where actually this tug of war game is been played like, you know, one team of Krishna, one team of Balaram, and the rule is whoever is not won or whoever loses, he has to carry the other team members on the back. Now here, this demon, Pralambasur, very powerful mystic demon. He had power to change his form. He has a power to change his form. So this is already happening. Now we see in the Hollywood and everyone, like youths come and they say, you know, in Hollywood this is happening, that happening. Or maybe sometime we are on YouTube, we see something like that. Change of face, change of form, change of voice. But this actually happened already. So then, What happened? Prahlambasur was very intelligent. He was waiting for the right opportunity. He was thinking that let me enter into their friend circle and then kill them. Kill Krishna and Balaram. Now, Prabhuji's and Mataji's, it's Maharaj Radhanath Maharaj explains that it's very, very dangerous, such kind of an anartha. Dushman ko ghus ke maarta hai, surgical strike karta hai. What it does? Surgical strike. It enters the enemy's area, zone, and it kills. So that is what Prahlambasura is. Yeah? And what is that anartha? Lust. And lust and pride. There are two types of lust, gross and subtle. And both are dangerous. Don't try to play with it. Radhanath Swami says that if you are trying to play with Maya and say kabaddi, 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 you know, and go and, you know, touch the line of the threshold line. Oh, I just, you know, yesterday I went to Maya's line and touched it and came back. How powerful I am. Radhanath Swami says, don't try to play. You know, because if you try to play with Maya, you may touch the line. But whatever practices you have been performing, the sadhana, it will go down and you won't realize. And again, you have to start from zero. And Maharaj says another powerful statement. Maharaj says that in your bhakti, if you are trying to practice devotional service with ease, who is seeing me? Let me perform practice, devotional service, aram se, you know. I can always watch TV at home, relax. Why am I supposed to go on Sunday feast programs? You know, Sunday is a very peaceful day. No one is observing me. And chalta hai na, thoda thoda, see, next day again, I am a devotee, yaar. You know, again I have kanti mala, tilak, dhoti kurta. Next Sunday ja ke devotee ban jayega. What's the problem? But this week I am relaxing, you know. And chalta, you know, it's okay, fine. But Balaramji is actually teaching us that we have to perform devotional service with intensity, with absorption. If you're not doing that, then this anartha, lust and pride, when they will enter, we don't know. And we'll be able to not realize they've entered and will be not be able to take even shelter of devotees. Services will be removed from our hand. Whatever little experience I have got in my life, and what are the acharyas saying is very true, and that services will be taken from your hand because you have taken it very easily. You know, that, oh, that Prabhu will do it. He will do it. That time will come when there you will be having no seva. And you will be sitting idle in the same temple hall where you were so much busy doing seva. So that's where these anarthas are actually going to trouble us. And the pastime of Prahlambasur continues. He's very intelligent. So the day when one of the gopas is on holiday, he's a little sick. He becomes that gopa and he's entered the friend's team. And now he realizes that, you know, Krishna, I'll kill him, but Balaram seems to be more powerful. Bade bhai ko pehle marega, to chota bhai khatam. If you kill the elder brother, younger brother is dead. So he plays that strategy and he comes in the team of Krishna. And Krishna team loses, wins, because Krishna has to win. So Balaram is now carrying Prahlambasur. And Balaramji, as soon as Prahlambasur sits on his back, Balaramji realizes that this is the anartha, this is the lust, pride. He's a demon. And Balaramji is in the same form. Oh, it's reverse. Sorry. It's reverse. Balaramji has been lifted by Prahlambasur. Because why? Because I remember the statement where Maharaj says that someone becomes heavier than the heavy. Now, of course, Prahlamba cannot become heavier than heavy. So somebody who's heavier than heavy has to be on top. So it's Balaram who is on the top. Lord Balaram is on the top. Prahlambasur is feeling, oh, very tired. fatigue. Huh? So when guru means heavy. Huh? When you are not practicing devotional services nicely, you will feel bhakti to be heavy. Aaj mala hi nahi ho raha hai. I could not chant my rounds nicely. When we become sick, chanting becomes so difficult. Vrajvihari Prabhu was telling, out of the context, I just like to share this point, very useful point for devotional service, that actually, you know, when we become devotee, we think that, okay, you know, I love Krishna, that's why I became devotee. There's an interview by a TV channel, okay, Prabhu, Mata, why you become a devotee? I love Krishna. And so on. But then we realize that after 10, 15, 20 years of bhakti, actually are we loving for Krishna, loving Krishna? Actually we're doing anya abhilashita shunyam? Are our other desires dead? Then we realize actually I came to bhakti not in love of Krishna, but got fascinated by some kirtan, some attracted. Of course, we have to get attracted. But that was not love of Krishna. Pure love of Krishna was not that. So actually we are still having many other desires than to serve Krishna. Because it's not anya abhilashita shunyam. It's not. So what is the process? The process is to follow the instructions of Guru. And how do we follow the instructions of Guru? By serving. By removing the anarthas. By consistently taking efforts to work on this path. Otherwise, progress is not guaranteed. And the last point, and we'll try to wind up now. The last word is M, mercy. So over here, in this pastime, Palambasur get mercy of Balaram ji. And what is that mercy? A blow on the head. A blow on the head. When you are not able to practice your devotional service nicely, if you realize, sometime you get a blow. And you are pulled. You are pulled out and there is a festival, Balaram Jayanti. Wow. And as soon as you enter the temple hall, a devotee says, Prabhu, yahan, do this. Chalo, ye karo, wo karo. And the whole day is gone in temple and you don't realize that actually you have been not uplifted, you are not so much enthusiastic, but by the mercy of Guru and Vaishnavas, you've been uplifted. When you are stuck up, an expert swimmer, when he's stuck up in the waves of the oceans, what happens? He tries to come out. There was a devotee, we went to Jagannath Puri Yatra in 2001, there was a devotee who went in the ocean and he thought he knew swimming, he was a swimming pool swimmer. But he did never swimmed in the ocean, he went inside, he could not come out, thinking himself to be expert. The problem with the experts is they think themselves to be experts. But actually Krishna is a supreme expert, Balaram is a supreme expert. So he was trying to come out and he could not come out. In our life also, when we are stuck up in such situations, the dark clouds in our life, we cannot come out on our own. What we need is we need the mercy of Guru. A big wave came and that wave just pulled that person outside, out of that undercurrent and could found himself saved. Similarly, we have to take mercy. We have to beg for the mercy of Balaram. Lord Nityanand Prabhu. It is Lord Nityanand Prabhu who actually convinced Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur to write Chaitanya Charitamrita. That's how we could get the nectar of the life and teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, without the mercy of Shri Balaram ji, without the mercy of Guru, we cannot move ahead in our spiritual life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Balaram ji ki. Yeah.